colonial cosme. Paraguay, South America, via New Zealand and Montevideo. Mr. Henry Wilson, Sydney. The 5th of August, 1896. Dear Harry.
Common in Paraguay, this high Thank you. 1903, the entire red page, the literary page of the Bulletin, is devoted to Mary Gilmore's life and poetry. At her home in Strathdowney East in Victoria, Mary is torn between excitement and trepidation at the changes this may bring to her life. She writes, again, to Mr. A.G. Stevens, editor of the Bulletin.
You must see something in my verses that you have given them so much thought and me of so much space.
Yeah.
to reconcile what she sees as her duty as wife and mother with her aspirations for herself as a writer. On the 25th of November, 1910, she writes to Mr. Edward Traeger, a writer and journalist living in New Zealand.
You know how you sit sometimes, your mind in a somewhat detached condition, yet working rapidly or intensely? A butterfly comes flitting in at the door. He was a stranger, a foreigner to all your thought, yet at once filling all your attention. That is how I usually find my work comes. Generally, in my verse, the last line is the only one that flashes into my mind. The climax line. The one clearly defined point in a whole inchoate yet shaped and unseen yet perceived. The whole is built from that central idea, sometimes without need or a word, though sometimes a line battles for years or even a word. My verse, as Mr. Stevens says, a series of little flutters. It comes all in one like a whirlwind, and if you don't box your whirlwind in time, well, you can by pursuing it. As to whether the verses are me, the only thing that I know is that they are the sincere cry of the heart. In the better and true ones, and the wound in the lesser ones. They weren't written with pens, but with every cell, that sense of being in whatever is actual, in what is really me. A long time.